compact fluorescent lights have improved quite a bit over the years. They start faster. They've become smaller, so they'll fit into more of your lamps and fixtures than what some of the older models did. And they have since improved the starting temperature to where you can use these outside. And a lot of these would not work on a dusk to dawn sensor or switch, but they will now. I'm using these outside for floodlights. When they first come on, they're a little bit purple. It takes them a couple of minutes to get up to temperature. Then once they're up and running, this light is about the equivalent of a 60 watt floodlight. It's not bad. And this will start down to about minus 10 degrees Fahrenheit, which is pretty good. This light is very similar to one of these. It just has a glass dome installed over the top of one of these, like so. And then it's sealed around the edge here to make it weatherproof. Now they say that one of these will last about 5 years. It really depends on the application. When I buy one of these bulbs, I write the date, how long it's supposed to last, and where I got it. And then I try to keep the receipt for it. I have some of these that have been on a dusk to dawn light outside since I bought them, which these were purchased in 2003. So I know I have some of these that have over 30,000 hours on them. The stated life on most of these are 6 to 15,000 hours. The dusk to dawn lights, they come on and they stay on till the sun comes up. They switch off. They have the advantage of being outside in an open fixture. Airflow around them is better. And in the wintertime, they're operating in fairly cool condition. I've used a couple of these in the house. I doubt that I've had even 2,000 hours. They do not like being turned on and off frequently. They do not like being inside a closed fixture. This one here was operating outside, and you can see the color changes, and that's from this ballast getting hot. One problem I've had with these lights is that this globe is sealed into this socket with something that's not much better than a cheap bathroom caulking material, and you'll sometimes notice that this outside globe will get loose. Well, that's not good, because you don't want moisture in that to get inside here. So you can wiggle that around and pull that off with a knife and clean up that putty around there, clean out that socket, and then I take silicone and reseal it, put it back into service, and it works just fine. How does a compact fluorescent light work? Electric comes from the socket through these wires into this circuitry. There are some diodes in here that rectify alternating current to pulsating DC current, some power transistors, capacitors, resistors, a few filters to try and eliminate radio frequency noise, and finally it comes to a transformer that steps the voltage to 600 volts. Two wires come to each side of the bulb. High voltage electric excites the gas inside the tube, creates invisible or ultraviolet light. The phosphor, or this white coating inside the bulb, converts that light to visible light that we can use. These were originally fairly cool or blue in color. They've improved the light to where the light is warmer, something more consistent with what we expect from an incandescent bulb. And that basically is how a mini fluorescent light works. The only difference between this and the long straight tubes that you're accustomed to in a house or an office, they've made them smaller in diameter. They've curled them up so they'll fit into a light fixture or a table lamp and take up less space. They've also improved the phosphors in terms of the visible light that they produce, the efficiency of the ballast, power consumption is less, and the lights come on quicker. So they keep getting better. In terms of bang for the buck, I like these primarily because I don't have to change them all the time. Some of the made overseas incandescent bulbs only last a week. I've had some of them fail the first time I turn them on. I know when I put one of these in, I'm not going to be changing it every time I turn around. They do not like to be turned on and off frequently. They do not like to be in an enclosed fixture where they get hot. The newer compact fluorescents are called CCFL. They're a cold cathode fluorescent light, and they're referred to as instant on. Their operating voltage is 5 times higher, but they have a life of about 50,000 hours. I have not had an opportunity to experiment with one of those. If you think one of these lights has become dimmer since you've had it, you're probably correct. These will lose 20 to 30% of their brightness over the life of the bulb. Also, these can interfere with your remote control for your stereo or your TV or recorder. I've had my TV turn off. I've had it change channels by itself, and I've oftentimes blamed the TV, but it's more than likely the light coming off of one of these bulbs has interfered with the infrared sensor. The base of these bulbs have quite a bit of information: manufacturer's name, wattage, amperage. This particular one is Commercial Electric. They've got a customer service 1-800 number on here. You can call them, tell them that you've had a bulb failure. Commercial Electric was pretty good initially. Then they get your name and phone number in their computer, and they'll ask, well, why are you calling about a bad bulb again? And if you've bought these in packs of 5 or 8, and you've purchased one or more packs, there's a good chance you're going to have several failures. At that point in time, they become a little difficult to deal with. I'd say I'm batting about a 50% average on getting them to stand good to their product. Buy your bulbs when they're on sale. Buy them by the box. They'll be $1.50, $2 each, and that's an economic price.